Hi, this is JP from Nautilats over Arkham. I decided to continue playing with the Systemary with the Winchester build after playing the House Always Wins scenario. I enjoyed the deck so much that I decided I will play it through a campaign. So I'm continuing this time in the return to extracurricular activities. And we are pre-experience richer after the House Always Wins, so I added charisma to the deck. There are no other changes to the first version. The Arkham DP was fast enough to add the new taboo list, so let's check the Winchester out quickly. So the previous version of the Winchester red fight action fight, you get +2 attack for this attack or combat for this attack if a +1/+0 or elder sign token is revealed during this attack. This attack deals +2 damage. And now after the taboo change, it reads action, spend 1 ammo. Oh yeah, and the Winchester didn't use any ammo previously. Now it reads spend 1 ammo, fight, you get +2 combat for this attack. If a chaos token with a non-negative modifier is revealed during this attack deals +2 damage. So as we saw, the ability of Systemary to add blessed tokens into the back really boosts this card, and you are able to regularly hit the right chaos token, especially with the help of Olive McBride. And now that we have a Dr. Francis Morgan in the deck, I added charisma into the deck so that we get some damage soak into Sister Mary. Her health of 5 is a big hindrance to the deck, but with the help of damage soaks, I think we can get a lot farther. We are playing the extra cool activity on return to version, and we are starting from the Miskatonic quad. So that's enough of the deck and the scenario. Let's get started. So the last thing we need to do before we start is to add 2 blessed tokens into the back with Systemary setup instruction, and we are ready to draw our opening hand. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's see what we get. Okay, we get the Winchester right away. We actually get 2 of the Winchesters, we don't need both. Okay, so we get everything we need. We get Olive McBride, 6 cents. So I'm definitely mulliganing the other Winchester and Dave Grenfield. We get take the initiative and Ward of Protection. So let's shuffle these back into the deck. The one thing I would have wanted to see was the, let's see, the Rite of Sanctification. This really helped me set up everything I needed in the start of the last scenario. I had some doubts about that card, but now I feel it's really helpful to set up a expensive asset build like this one, where you need a lot of resources to get everything down as fast as possible. Okay, I think the deck is shuffled. Let's start playing. First action, I think I will, because there are not that many enemies that can do anything to us right at the start, I'll play the Sixth Sense and Olive McBride. So that is all of our resources. And last action, let's move into the Warren Observatory. So, Warren Observatory is a four-shot location with one clue. First, after you discover one or more clues at Warren Observatory, discard three cards from the top of your deck for each clue just discovered. And it's a victory one location. Okay, and this Ethereal security guard will hunt in the enemy phase, hunt to the Miskatonic quad, and we ready, we draw a card, we get another board of protection, and we gain one resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. The threshold is 7 doom. We get an encounter card, and we get Eldritch Accord, Peril, Revelation. You may draw one card. You may choose and discard up to two cards from your hand. Test, Willpower X. If you fail, take two horror. X equals the number of cards in your hand when this test begins. So, I think... I think I'll just draw the card and I'll discard two cards. Don't need those. So the test is willpower 3. If I ever fail, I'll take two horror. And that is fine. I have a horror soaking Olive McBride. I'm not using Olive for this test. Let's see how it goes. 4 versus 3. It's a minus 3, so I fail. I'll take the horror. I'll take both on. Well, I just take 1 and 1. That's fine. First action, I'll use Olive to investigate, and I'll take the initiative to the test. We are testing 7 versus 4. So, at the end of the last round, we got to add one less token. So this is starting to be a ritual of mine to add them at the start of the investigation phase or the turn, rather than at the end. We'll see. So 7 versus 4. Okay, so this is a minus 1, so we'll cancel the minus 3. So we get minus 2, so we succeed. We get this clue. And second action, we'll take a resource, and last action we'll take a resource. Okay, and yeah, and we forgot to discard three cards from the top of our deck. Oh, we discarded another prepared for the worst, take the initiative, and unfortunately Dr. Francis Morgan. But what can you do? Enemy base. Security guard hunts here. Hits us for 1 damage. And we go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get another Olive Pride and 1 resource. And we add a bless token into the back. So this time we remembered. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. The encounter card is Wizard of Yogg-Sothoth. Okay, this is really bad. So it comes into play, engages us. This might be a short game. I have to take a lot of damage to deal with both of these now. So, first action, we'll take attacks of opportunity from both of these, so 2 damage and 2 horror, but we get the Winchester in play. Comes into play with 5 ammo. Second action, we'll use the Winchester to shoot at the Wizard of Yogg-Sothoth, and I'll actually commit the Ward of Protection to the test and use Olive. Okay, so we need to hit something that triggers the plus damage, so we draw 3 tokens. Okay, luckily we got the blessed token, so we will defeat that guy if we don't get auto fail for this. Well, we got a 0, so I picked the skull, which is a -1, and 0 plus 2, so the Wizard of Yogg-Sothoth is defeated. So we get that into the victory display. It's a victory. 1 enemy, so that's good news. As last action, I try to shoot this guy again. So we really need to hit the bless token here. And it's a 0, thank God, so this guy is defeated. And yeah, well, we are hurting, but we may still pull through. So, so no enemies, we go to upkeep, we ready up, draw a card. Oh yeah, these resources are gone. We gain 1 resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We have 3 Doom of 7. The encounter card is a secret door. That's the location with the most investigators. And without the secret door attached, investigators cannot leave this location. Test willpower 3 for search for the passage or knowledge 3 to descend the way out. If you succeed, discard the secret door. Okay, so first action, we'll do the willpower check. Let's see if we can find a way out. It's an elder sign, and actually we forgot to add 1 at the end of the round, and now we add 1 more. So we managed to find a way out of this secret door. We'll move down here. We get to the humanities building. It's a 3 sharp location with 2 clues. Pause at the end of your turn. If you are in the humanities building, discard the top X cards of your deck where X is the amount of horror on you. I think we'll go search for the clues elsewhere. Last action, we'll move to the quad. We don't want to discard any cards. And no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get the 45 automatic and 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. And the encounter card is Visions of Futures Past. Test willpower 5. For each point you fail by, discard the top card of your deck. So we are testing 5 versus 4 versus 5. Yeah. Oh yeah, and we again forgot to add 1. End of the round. Well, we are at 6 versus 5. 8 versus 5. And minus 3, so 5 versus 5 is 0, so we don't have to discard anything. That's okay for me. First action, let's go check out the student. Let's actually go to the science building first. Okay, forced at the after science building is revealed, put the set aside alchemy labs in play. And alchemy labs reads the door leading into the alchemy labs is locked. You cannot move into the alchemy labs. So we will investigate here. Investigating 4 versus 2. I'll use olive. So we have to cancel that. So this is unfortunately minus 3. So we are failing. So we have to discard the top 3 cards. We discard 45 automatic, drawn to the flame, and another sixth sense. Okay, last action. Oh dear. We failed a willpower check here, so we take 1 damage, which means I'll actually kill off Olive. Okay. Last action, we will play Olive again. So this Olive is discarded and we'll play Olive again. Okay. Well, that was interesting. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get the Hallowed Mirror, which will help a lot. Now we just need resources to play it. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 doom of 7. The encounter card is Light of Aforgomon. Attach revelation. You must attach Light of Aforgomon to either the current agenda or the current act. Limit 1 per agenda or act. Treat all damage and direct damage as direct damage and all horror as direct horror. So I think the agenda will advance earlier. I'll attach this to the agenda. Just put it over here. First action will investigate. Investigating. I'll just investigate. Oh yeah, and we forgot to add a less token last turn. So I'm investigating without the help of Olive. So it's a less token, 6 versus 2. Another less, 8 versus 2. Let's see. Okay, a 0. So we get this clue. These are gone. Next action will move here. Last action will go to the student union. Okay, it's a one short location with 2 clues. And that is the... Oh yeah, and we put the dormitories into play. But they are also locked, so we can't move into them yet. No enemies, upkeep, we draw a card, we get scene of the crime, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Oh yeah, now we add the blessed token at the end of the round. Let's go to the next round. We are at 6 doom. The counter card is a playful welcome peril. Choose two of the following action: investigate, fight, evade, move, or play. For the remainder of the round, each investigator cannot perform each chosen action. Okay, so I'll choose evade. And I'll choose evade and move. So we can't move or evade. That's okay. First action, I'll play the hallowed mirror. We get one soothing melody in hand and two in the deck. Second action, I think I'll play the soothing melody. I'll heal two damage. Draw card. We get second wind. Last action, I'll investigate. I'll use Olive. So I'll pick these two. Okay, yeah, these two. Let's see. Actually, I won't even pick that. So I think I'll have to see where this goes before I pick it. So it's a minus two. Okay, so I'll just pick this. So I succeed, I'll get the clue, and I will use the clues to advance. So, the head janitor. Shuffle the encounter discard pile and set aside Jazz Mulligan into the encounter deck. So we have Jazz here. That's every action done. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. Okay, so we get the tower. We can commit cards to skill tests. And we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. The agenda advances. So this goes away. Something stirs. Each investigator with 5 or more cards in his or her discard pile takes 1 horror. Each investigator with 10 or more cards in their discard pile takes 2 horror. Yeah, I have more than 10, so I'll take 2 horror. I'll just take it on myself. Actually, I'll take it on Olive now that there isn't prevented. If the players have completed the household always wins, advance directly to agenda 2B. So we go to agenda 2B. An experiment gone wrong. If the dormitory's location is not in play, put it in play. If the experiment is in play, move it one location towards the dormitories. If the experiment is not in play, spawn it in the science building. So I'll just put the experiment here. Okay, so it has 10 health. We have 3 bullets, which isn't enough to kill it. I think we really need to find Jazz and find another resolution. So, the beast unleashed. When this agenda would advance by reaching its doom threshold, instead remove all doom in play and move the experiment one location towards the dormitories. If the experiment enters the dormitories, advance. Okay, and we still need to find Jazz. So we have a action, spend one clue, discard the top 5 cards, top 10 cards if playing a one player game. If you discard Jazz Mulligan for any reason, resolve his revelation effect. Okay. So first action, I'll just investigate here. I'm investigating 4 versus 1. Actually, yeah, we still haven't drawn the encounter card this turn. Baleful welcome. So I won't evade and fight this turn. Now let's pull. So 4 versus 1. It's a 0. We get this clue. I will use the clue and discard 10 cards. So let's see if we discard Jazz, Paper Wheel, Infinite Doorway, Beyond the Veil, Secret Door, Haunting Reflection, Security Guard times 2, Eldritch Accord, Visions of Future Past, and Infinite Doorway. So no Jazz, unfortunately. Last action, I think we have to move to the quad and go look for more clues. And enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep, we draw a card. Okay, yeah. So we get a soothing melody and one resource, we add a bless token to the deck. That is our turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card is Eager for Death. Test willpower 2. Increase this skill test difficulty by 1 for each damage on you. If you fail, take 2 horror. So the difficulty is 3. So 4 versus 3, it's a bless token, so I'm 6 versus 3, minus 1, so we succeed, so we don't take any damage. First action, we'll move to the administration building. 4, shroud, 1 clue. Second action, we can't commit anything to this test, so I'm just testing 4 versus. Oh yeah, we put the faculty offices in play. It's locked also. Investigating 4 versus 4. I'm using Olive. I have to hit the less token to have a better chance. Okay, so we hit a 0 and a bless. Let's see what the bless has with it. Another bless. And a minus 4. So we'll pick this conga line and this. So it's a 0 altogether. We succeed, we get this clue, which was here. And last action, we'll spend the clue to search for Jazz. So let's see, Beyond the Veil, Thrall, Visions of Future Past, times 2, another Beyond the Veil, Haunting Recollection, Vassal of the Lurker, Light Gormon and Eldritch and a Troll. So still no Jazz. Well, this is getting really hard. No active enemies. We go to upkeep. At the end of your turn, if you are in the administration building, discard the top card of your deck. So we discard David Renfield and we draw a card. And we gain a resource. so we get evidence, which might be helpful. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah, Olive is ready, and now we can go to the next turn after we add the blessed token into the back. So this agenda advances. So this doesn't advance, we just remove the doom, and the experiment advances one location. Encounter card is... after all, location with the most clues, so it goes there. Okay, I think we'll take one resource. We'll play the tower. And I think we'll heal one damage and one horror. Draw a card. And that is our turn. No hunting enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we hit the Crisis of Fate. So, I have two bless tokens in the back, so I'll just take the two horror. And that is it. We add less token into the back, and yeah, one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, and then the encounter card is okay. So Jazz is here. So Revelation, put Jazz Mulligan into play at your location. While Jazz Mulligan is not controlled by an investigator, he gains action power latest intellect 3. If successful, take control of Jazz Mulligan. While you control Jazz Mulligan, you ignore the text on its unrevealed location. Okay, and I'm committing the evidence to this test. Actually, let's premonition. Okay, so it's a blessed token. Well, that's helpful. So I would be one up. So I still think I'll commit the evidence. So I'm three up. So we use that and we get a minus one. Okay. So we succeed. And we get control of Jazz. And second action. I think we'll go check this out. Okay, so oh yeah, these are so nothing here. The hour is late, so yeah, that's so we are not able to rescue Warren Rice, so we'll go back to the administration building. And at the end of my turn, I'll discard one card. And we discard the Guardian Angel, which is a shame. That is that turn. We'll no hunting enemies, we draw a card, we get Dave Renfield, and gain one resource. So, and we add one bless token to the back. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, so the agenda advances and the experiment moves one towards here. And we get an encounter card, which is Resurgent Evils. Draw the top two cards of the encounter deck or place one doom on the current agenda. I have to draw the encounter cards. So we get a Whippoorwill, that's fine. And we get Eager for Death, which is fine. I'll commit actually. Commit the second win to the test. It's a minus 4. So take 2 horror. I'll cancel the horror with the deny existence. And that is that. And the Whippoorwill is here. I think we just have to run past the experiment and take the attack of opportunity. So one move here, second move here, and it's massive, so we just run past and take 2 damage and 2 horror, and I'm able to take it all on myself. And we reveal the dormitories, so 3 clues, Shroud of 1. We really need to get these clues off so we can get the resolution 1. And that is our turn. So no hunting enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw a card. And we gain 1 resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom here, encounter card is Baleful Welcome. Well, we say that we don't move or fight. And that is that. So I think first thing we do is we play Scene of the Crime. We get 1 clue. Second action is we'll actually use Olive, so investigating four versus 1. Oh yeah, we forgot to add a bless token at the end of the last round, so okay. Okay, let's see these bless tokens, what they are. Oh dear. So I think we have to pick these. I'm just counting. I'm 4, 5, 6. 2 up, 1 up. Yeah, I still succeed, but just barely. So I get 1 clue. And last action, we'll premonition this. And it's a 0, so I'll just commit David Renfield to the test and investigate last time. Get this clue. And I'm able to spend the clues and get resolution 2. That was pretty close. So, resolution 2. In your campaign log, record that Professor Warren Rice was kidnapped. In your campaign log, record that the students were rescued. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value on the victory display. We have 1 here, 1 here and 1 here, so we get 3 experience. We proceed to interlude 1 Armitage Fate. We rescued Dr. Henry Armitage, and we can add him to the to the deck. So we get Henry Armitage. Then we continue to the scenario 2, Miskatonic Museum. That is the second scenario played. We didn't get to use the Winchester that much this game, but we had it in a crucial moment of the scenario, so we could defeat the wizard of the of Yog-Sothoth with it. And I think this deck is working pretty good. This was the extracurricular activity with Winch Sister Mary. So thanks for watching, and until next time.